Welcome back to the Roundtable. I'm Retro Nemo, and today we're going to give you Gumball fans out there a breakdown of the Season 6 premiere, The Arrival. This episode is riddled with fast jokes, references, and Easter eggs in typical Gumball fashion, so let's jump right in. This episode takes place 4 years in the past, depicting the birth of their sister, Anaïs, and how the three had a bit of a rocky start. Basically, Anaïs is an evil baby genius, hell-bent on making Gumball and Darwin's lives as awful as they could be. Like I said, the episode is just riddled with references and Easter eggs, so let's break this down. Fans of Gumball may recognize the Cole and Richard's outfits this episode. They're the same exact outfits as the ones they wore in a flashback scene from the previous episode, The Choices. Despite this, it's a direct continuity error, as Nicole and Richard were shown much more grown with their present-day designs, such as a shaved Richard, when Anaïs was born in The Choices. Now, you could argue that Anaïs' scene just happens in a later point in time, or that Richard shaved to get a job, or even that Nicole got her current job. There's a lot of possibilities here that cover up for it. Gumball and Darwin reference playing Knights and Princesses, a common children's game usually played kindergarten to elementary. Their princess outfits may look familiar, as Gumball looks an awful lot like Rapunzel with his long blonde hair, and Darwin seems to look a lot like Belle with a few small discrepancies. In the fantasy sequence where Gumball is about to kick the Apple Kid, the kid is actually Banana Joe's cousin from the episode The Name, who Gumball takes a bite out of during his cool sequence, leaving Apple Kid crying in pain. Jeez, it seems like Gumball is just terrorizing this kid. The devious face Anaïs repeatedly makes throughout the episode could be a reference to Pennywise from the horror movie It. The program on the TV screen as Gumball and Darwin walk back into the house is a direct parallel to the episode. It shows two eggs behind an eagle that hatches. The eagle refuses to share space and pushes the eggs off the nest. This is exactly what Anaïs is doing to Gumball and Darwin. The face Gumball and Darwin make when they listen to the TV announcer is a popular meme reference to the Enel face from One Piece. The face itself has appeared numerous times throughout the manga and anime on various characters and has circulated throughout the internet in past years. Darwin calling Nicole and Richard Mrs. Mom and Mr. Dad shows he's still adjusting from his adoption with them, not viewing them quite as his own family yet. When the two almost die, and Darwin tries to leave, Gumball says the line, "At least your soul was going upwards." Gumball was going to hell even from a young age. The line, "It's a trap," is a reference to Admiral Ackbar from Star Wars. Anaïs says the line, "War does not determine who is right, only who is left," which is a direct quote from Bertrand Russell, the British philosopher, logician, mathematician, historian, writer, social critic, political activist, and Nobel laureate. This just shows how incredibly intelligent Anaïs is, even from a young age. I mean, I didn't even know who this guy was. This episode marks the second time Gumball is almost killed in a junkyard. The first was in The Hero. This cat just needs to stay away from junkyards, jeez. When Gumball is squashed in the junkyard, he breaks the fourth wall by saying, "I guess there's advantage for being 2D. Gumball heading towards his fire demise in a garbage dump and getting rescued is very similar to Toy Story 3's iconic scene. Anaïs appearing behind Gumball and Darwin saying, "Time to fly to the nest," is similar to Pennywise appearing behind people and saying, "Time to float." Anaïs is just basically Pennywise, guys, let's be real here. Okay, so there you go, those were all of the Easter eggs and references in the episode of Gumball, The Revival. Let's know if there's any we missed in the comments down below. Tweet to us at Roundtable Vids or at me at It's Retro Nemo. Finally, like and share this video if you liked it and subscribe to the Roundtable for more great cartoon content. I'm Retro Nemo, this is a cartoon breakdown, and I'll see you guys in the next video.